There was a little honeymoon period when I made that video. Why has this thing become the world's most expensive paperweight? I would not recommend it. It's not gonna be a great experience, in my opinion. So it has been over 1 year since I initially bought the Peloton Bike Plus and I made my initial Peloton review video. I just want to come back and just fill you in on how I've been liking the Peloton over the past year. Am I still using it? Do I still like it? Or has this thing become the world's most expensive paperweight and is it just collecting dust a year later? I'm gonna tell you all of that as well as a few updates since my last review video. Let's get into it. Now, over this past year, we have put this bike through a lot. It has been through almost 400 cycling classes between me and my husband, and we've also done 2 long distance moves with this bike. So there's been really a lot of opportunities for things to go wrong with the physical condition of this bike. And I have to say about 90% of the bike is still in great condition. The screen, handlebars, seat, the weights. The only area that is really showing a lot of heavy wear is the pedals. And unfortunately, we're getting to a point where I think the pedals will have to be replaced. I noticed this a few months ago where the shoes were getting progressively more difficult to snap into place. I wasn't really getting that satisfying click sound that you're used to when you snap in the pedals, and it was just getting more dull and dull over time. And unfortunately, now it's come to the point where we really can't use the bike unless we replace the pedals. So I just placed an order to buy new pedals from Peloton. They are $60 to buy replacement pedals, and they actually recommend this on the Peloton website to do annually, which is definitely not something I realized when I bought the bike. So definitely keep that in mind that you will likely have to replace the pedals at some point. The good news is that it's not all bad news from my Peloton. They have actually come out with some new features over the past year, which I think are big improvements. So they do now allow you to pause classes. This is something that I really just never understood about the Peloton system and why this was not an option, but now you can pause classes. The only thing to note is that if you pause a live class, you no longer are going to be ranked on the leaderboard, but you will still be able to high five people and still use all the other features. Also note that you can only pause for a limited amount of time. I think it's only 1 hour. And then on top of that, they have continued to put out new types of content basically all the time. Like there's new content types like foam rolling and things like that. So I've been really impressed with the volume and quality of new content and new content types coming out over the past year. On top of that, there's also a few clarifications and just other things that I want to update you on from my past video. So in my initial video, I said this: you can't pull up Hulu, Netflix, YouTube, anything else on the big screen. And I just want to make a quick clarification on that. I have learned since making that video that technically it is possible to use the Peloton screen to access a web browser and watch things like YouTube or Netflix, Hulu, etc. But I still stand by my statement that Peloton does not support this. And so in order to do that, you will have to exit the Peloton app and basically like jerry-rig your way to watch that other type of content. And when you do that, unfortunately, you're not going to be able to track any of your metrics or really have the integration of the Peloton system where you can control resistance and like look at the calories you've burned and stuff like that. Yes, you will be technically on the bike, but you're not part of the Peloton system anymore. So I still stand by that, but I do want to clarify that technically there is a way to access a web browser on the Peloton screen, but it's not supported by Peloton, and I still would not buy one thinking that is what you're gonna do, because I would not recommend it. It's not gonna be a great experience, in my opinion. And finally, another thing that has come up many times since my initial video, specifically I said this:
cycling shoes are required this bike.
Technically, you don't have to buy the shoes. Technically, you can buy toe cages, and Peloton does sell these, although you can also get these from third-party sites and third-party vendors. Personally, I did try some third-party toe cages. I tried that out in my Peloton accessories video, which I will put around here. Long story short, I do not recommend toe cages. I think they are a much, much worse experience. Number one, toe cages are an enormous pain to put on and off. I mean, maybe it was just the ones I tried, but the ones I tried were literally terrible to get on and off. It's gonna be a giant pain, and at that point you may well just buy an extra set of shoes, honestly, because it's not fun to do that. And then the second thing that you're gonna wanna think about is toe cages just do not feel as secure as having shoes with cleats. When you are cycling really quickly or you're standing up in the pedals, it's not as safe from my perspective because you're more likely to have your feet slip out and have the pedals like wrap around and hit you in the shin. So yeah, you're gonna wanna really be careful of that as well. But ultimately, I think the question that is probably on your minds is, am I still actually using the Peloton a year later, or has it just, you know, did it have its time? There was a little honeymoon period when I made that video, and now it's kind of lost interest. I think the short answer is I still feel the same way about the Peloton as I did at the beginning. I still think it's a really great product. I really like the classes still. I think the content that they put out is still really great. I think the instructors are really motivational. I like the music, and they are constantly coming out with new material, which I really appreciate. But that being said, I really am not using it as much as I was in the beginning. And the short answer for why that is I have more options now, like way more options than I did when I initially purchased the Peloton. So I got the Peloton in the height of the pandemic. I think it was September or something of 2020. And I was living in San Francisco at the time that had so uber strict rules around COVID. All the gyms were closed, all the fitness studios were closed. It made it really hard to just run on the sidewalk because people give you dirty looks if you aren't wearing a mask. And even at home workouts were not that great of an option for me to do any type of cardio because let's just say my downstairs neighbor was very sensitive to any type of noise. And literally, I kid you not, one time I did literally 10 jumping jacks, literally. And I'm pretty sure within 5 jumping jacks in, she was texting the manager of my building, like tattletaling on me that I was doing at home workouts and I was making noise in my apartment. And after that, I was like, okay, screw it. I'm not doing any like dynamic movements in my house. So when the Peloton came around, I was like, thank the heavens. This is the solution to all of my problems. I can work out now. I don't have to make any noise. I don't have to wear a mask. It's very quiet. I'm not gonna make any noise downstairs. It basically solved all my problems. And as a result of that, I use the Peloton every single day for months. Like, I think I had a daily streak going for, I wanna say, about 6 months where I use the Peloton every single day. And if I wasn't doing a cycling class and then I was doing a, or if I wasn't doing that, I would do a strength or a stretching or a meditation. I used the app and I was like fully ingrained using it all the time. Gordon. Now I'm at the point where I have a lot more options for working out. I'm actually training for a half marathon right now, so I'm doing a lot of outdoor running. The gyms are open again, studios are open again. At the end of the day, I really love having a variety in my workout, so I no longer use the Peloton nearly as much as I did at the beginning. I probably do about 1 cycling class per week, and then I'll usually do 1 or 2 other classes every week. Normally, I've been doing stretching or some of the strength classes. I just have more options now. I go to the gym, I do different studio classes, and I still love the Peloton and I think it's a really great option. But personally, I just like having more of a variety at the end of the day. But I think if you are someone who doesn't want to have a bunch of different memberships, you don't want to have to go to the gym, or you don't want to run outside, or you don't want to do those other things, and you just want to have a really convenient option in your own home, I would still really recommend it. But for me personally, that's kind of why I'm not using it quite as much as I did at the beginning. So all of that being said, would I still recommend the Peloton a year later? The answer to that is yes, I would. I would still recommend it. And if you want to know all of my thoughts on it, like not just the quick updates that I made in this video, I really recommend checking out my original Peloton review video. Yeah, that's it. If you want to see more reviews in the future, definitely let me know what other at-home fitness equipment that you would like to see me review. I'm gonna try to get another 1 or 2 of them this year to review for you guys. And until next time. Bye.